considered how you're gonna handle the remaining balance on your loan?
No, that's for sure.
Has anyone gone over the options with you?
No.
Okay. When it comes to remaining balance on the loan, there's actually three options. Mm-hmm. Okay, the first option is write a check for the full balance.
All right.
I gotta tell you, this is very difficult to do.
Yep.
Not a lot of people can do it, okay?
Yeah.
I don't have $23,000 just to write a check.
Yeah.
The benefit of doing so, though, you're gonna transfer full equity from your vehicle over to the next one, okay? It's gonna put you in a better position, i.e. we're looking at a negative balance now, you'd be positive the next go around.
Yeah.
Your second option is gonna be to, and I've seen people do as much as half, is write a check for a portion of a loan.
Mm-hmm.
$5,000, $10,000, it does the same thing. It lowers your monthly payments, yeah. Puts you in a better equity position. Last option is gonna be, and this is pending bank approval, would be to roll the full amount into the loan.
All right.
Which is going to elevate your payment, obviously. I gotta put it in the computer for now. Which way do you think you would roughly wanna do this? Because it's not my means to handle you that. I hate your financials.
I guess the last one, I mean.
Okay, pending bank approval.
Yeah.
Okay, like I said, this is something at the point where I think we would have to grab, because your father is going to be an important part of this.
Yeah.
Okay. I would like to schedule a time for him to be able to come down so that we can put the rest of the numbers together.
All right.
And see also, since he's going to be on the loan as a primary as well, how he would like to handle it as well.
All right.
And give him an option to see the truck so that we can both put all the numbers together. All
right. So as of now, you don't have a monthly...
I can give you a best guesstimate, but payments are really going to depend on a couple of things.
Yeah.
This is why I'm going to need your father here as well.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, payment's going to boil down to, of course, and we got to look at the value pricing that we have for some of the local programs mm-hmm. that we can offer you. But the total amount that you're going to finance, like for this instance, and the term that you took, and 75, you know, the extra add-ons with the vehicle,
All
of that's going to determine your payment, also with your interest rate as well.
All right.
Yeah. So as an example, Pete, your last loan was about $25,000,
yeah.
And that equaled to a payment of how much exactly?
On a 75-month loan, John, that equaled to about $305,000.
So theoretically, right? So if $25,000 was $300,000,
yeah.
Essentially, right?
Yeah.
And how much is this truck we're looking at?
This one we're looking at is $28,000. So we're
increasing that amount, right? Plus on top of that, if you were choosing option three, which was to try to roll in the balance mm-hmm. of your loan, mm-hmm. you're essentially going to add, at that point, effectively, you're adding, you know, $20,000.
Yeah.
So you're going from 20 got you to three. So now we're adding another 20 and we're increasing in the value of the truck. So we're not 23. So we're about 43 at that point. So
yeah.
if 20 got you to three, 43 is going to be more like
six.
It wouldn't surprise me.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It wouldn't surprise me.
Yeah.
Of course, as Brad was just mentioning, the variables that are at play is the total amount that you guys choose to finance based on what your dad wants to do with the balance.
Yeah.
On top of that, the term that we can qualify you on the loan.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, the rate that we can qualify you for. Those are variables, but yeah, give or take in that range, that wouldn't surprise me at all.
Yeah, definitely, yeah.
You know, which again, I mean, quite frankly, you know, you're at a great payment on this one because you got the long term and a good rate, and that's why you're at such a low payment.
Yeah.
Do you know what national average payment is right now in the country? Do you have any idea what it is?
Right.
National average right now is 482.
All right.
So 482 is the national average. That's an average person buying an average car and having an average payment of 482, right?
Yeah.
So obviously, when you look at stepping into a truck, that's not an average vehicle.
Yeah.
You know, so so again, generally speaking, a payment in the close to 600. Absolutely very normal on a full-size truck like that.
Yeah.
And again, based on within your budgets, I'm sure you were kind of anticipating that the payment would go up.
Yeah, definitely.
Right?
Absolutely.
Yeah, cool.